Hallelujah. Let's go to the book of Hebrews, chapter number 11. We are continuing with the series. Hebrews chapter number 11, verse 3. Kazaba. Are you ready? Let's read. Sister Mary, you need to come this side. Are you good? Chapter 11, verse 3.
Katumel, reetse ba go ba ditho tsohle dipopilo e ka letswela modimo. Ka mogwa wa gore tse bonang ga di akatsa etswa ka tse bonagalang.
Is that the end of it? Right. So, it says by faith we know that the worlds. See, sometimes the Sotho Bible is not born again well. So, the worlds. The aeons. The periods of time. And the happenings. Within such frames of time were programmed by the word of God. Hallelujah. Now, I'm going to take us through the life of Christ to show us that his life was programmed. Every single thing in his life was already programmed. Where he went, who he met, every single thing that happened was not a coincidence. This tells you that you can live such a life that is programmed, that there are no coincidences in your life. You are living inside a prophetic destiny. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the series, like I said, is recreating your world. Understand that it is your responsibility to take advantage of the prophetic word and program your destiny within the prophetic word. Hallelujah. Before we continue, let's just let me give you the life of Joseph as an example. Hallelujah. Right, before I go there, now listen. Do you know that prophetically, spiritually, even what looks like a mistake is not a mistake?
I suppose.
Are you listening to it? When you read the Bible,
how about
the you find, for example, the life of Jacob. He wanted to marry
Rachel.
But he was given who? Leah, right? And he ended up having 12 kids, 12 sons, and a daughter. From Rachel, he had only two sons, Joseph and Benjamin. But when you arrive in heaven, you are going to find the Bible says the city, the new Jerusalem, has 12 foundations and the 12 gates. The 12 foundations are named after the apostles. The 12 gates are named after the 12 tribes of Jacob. But the question you ask yourself is this. So was the life of Jacob a mistake or it was a prophetic coincidence? Because this man, according to him, he did not want to meet Leah. And he was not supposed to meet the 12 concubines. He wanted Rachel. But it looks like in the spirit, there's a prophecy that must be fulfilled. His life is a mess because he is a victim of divine purpose. This man is a victim of divine purpose. Something must be fulfilled in heaven. But Jacob must be, and are you listening to what I'm saying, church? Now, Abraham had a wife and they struggled to have a child. And Sarah said, meet the seven called Haran. What is the name of the seven, right? And they end up having Ishmael. It looks like Ishmael is not supposed to exist at all. But the Bible says, when Joseph was sold, he was bought by the Ishmaelites.
You are not, oh my God. Do I have church in the house? The Ishmaelites bought Joseph, and Joseph is going to prepare the prophecy of Abraham. The prophecy of Abraham. Your children will be in Egypt for 400 years. That is the prophetic word.
Hallelujah. Sometimes what you call a mistake is not a mistake. It simply means you must miss it before you take it. Oh, sometimes mistake means you miss it before you take it. It's part of life. Are you listening to what I'm saying? When you read the book of Matthew chapter 1, you'll find a man called Solomon. Solomon is not supposed to be there. But David had to sleep with somebody's wife. It looks like a sin and a mistake. But this is a prophetic destiny. To the extent that when Solomon is born, God says, I love Solomon. I love Solomon. I choose Solomon. I love Solomon. But Solomon is not supposed to be here. You are judging David. But even David doesn't understand his life. He is a victim of divine purpose. When you read the book of Judges, chapter 13, I believe chapter 13, you find a man called Samson. Are you listening? For some reason, he loved the Philistine women. He loved the Philistine women. So the father said, can't you find a wife among your people? But the Bible says in Judges chapter 14 verse 4 that God wanted to use the anger of Samson. I'm telling you, the Bible says God wanted to use the anger of Samson to punish the Philistines. So even Samson doesn't understand his life. It is not his mistake. It is prophetic destiny working in this man. Hallelujah. Let's go to Psalm 105. My life is inside a prophetic program. Psalm 105, verse number 17.
Arumela motu, hoba etela pi. Josepha, arekela. Hoba mofo ya rua.
So stop here now. So, now, do you know that you are going to blame the brothers of Joseph? They hated his brother and sold him. But the Bible says it was not them. Prophetically, it was God who was sending Joseph to Egypt. So these guys are simply on the best side of prophecy. Because somehow Joseph must go to Egypt. The Bible says he was sent by God. That is why when he met them, he said, you meant it for evil, but God meant it for good. So even they did not understand. They were being programmed by the spiritual world. Sometimes your enemies don't, that's why don't hate them. They are part of prophecy. It's part of prophecy. Sometimes your ex will leave you. Don't blame them. It's part of prophecy. I'm telling you the truth. Do you know that Ruth had to lose her husband? It was part of prophecy. Because she must be the grandmother of Jesus. She must be the grandmother of Jesus. Somehow she must go through that pain of losing her husband and become a widow at a young age. But in the spirit, this is a destiny. And brother, are you aware that even when Saul made a mistake and lost the kingdom, it was prophetic.